Right now, we're going to talk about the fundamentals of the jab step. Now, as a ball handler, as someone who hasn't dribbled the basketball yet, I always want to dictate how the defense is going to play me. All right, great defensive players, great defensive teams, they're going to preach pressure defense and be all over me and make me react to the defense. No, as an offensive player, you want to dictate what the defense does. And the best way to do that before you dribble the basketball is using the jab step. So rule number one, when you catch, you've got to have a good athletic base getting low. All right, now the jab step starts after a good base with the establishment of a pivot foot. All right, and a pivot foot, all that means is that I plant one foot. For most right-handed players, it's gonna be your left foot, and that foot is anchored on the ground. And I can spin around like a top, and that is a perfectly legal basketball move, all right? The second that I spin around and I pick up this pivot foot, that's a travel, all right? So imagine you have your foot glued to the ground, but the good news is you can move in any direction with your other foot, and that's where the jab step comes in. So when I first catch the ball, I'm in good triple threat. I have my strong pivot foot, all right? I want to test to see how the defense is going to react to me. And so I give them the jab step, all right? Now, I like to call this squashing the bug. Ha! Ha! Especially for younger kids, they get that metaphor a little better. Squash that bug. Squash that bug. Squash that bug. Squash that bug. And essentially, that's the science of the jab step. You want the ball in the pocket right here, all right? Your shooting pocket. This is a good position for an offensive player because you can pass, you can shoot, or you can drive, all right? So to have a good position, ball position is key when doing the jab step. When I do the jab step, I'm gonna jab, I'm gonna squash that bug, and I need to do it with enough force to make the defense believe it, but I also can't do it too fast that I can't read what the defense is doing, okay? Because there are three reads I'm gonna make off the jab step. When I jab and the defender doesn't go anywhere, doesn't react to my jab step, that gives me an advantage. The defender is standing still, I'm already halfway past him, I can put the ball on the floor and go by him. Second read, if I jab and the defender is so scared of my driving ability that he takes a step back, I know that if I step back, I have created a tremendous amount of space to get my jump shot off. And thirdly, if I jab and the defender flies to the side I'm jabbing, I know I've created a driving lane going the other way, so I'm just gonna cross over and I've made my position. So those are the three reads when doing the jab step. Remember, do it forcefully, but don't do it so quickly that you can't read the defense. Because at the end of the day, the jab step has one goal in mind, create space for the offensive player.